up, everybody? Welcome back to episode 11 of The Homage Continues. My name is SC Static, and this week, we're going back to the West Coast for Casual. Yeah. Fear Itself, 1994. This is debut solo album, beat by Domingo. Man, I love that beat so much. This album, too, in its entirety is really funky, just like that beat, really dope, great for the summer, great for a day like today, at least in New York right now, it's good weather. This came out in 1994 on Jive Records. Casual is a member of the Hieroglyphics Collective. As we went over a couple weeks ago, for the Third Eye Vision album, I used their After Dark instrumental. I was going through, just kind of serendipitously looking for beats that I could use from their collective. I was looking for a couple beats off Adele's first album here, and I ended up sticking with this one. And they both happened to be Domino beats. Domino did the After Dark instrumental, and we got it like that instrumental off this project. I didn't know that for either of those until after the fact, so I must really like Domino's production, clearly, as well as A+ and the rest of the Hieroglyphic members who are featured on this album as producers. So you got Domino, as I said, he did 8 beats on here. Domino did 8 beats on here. You got 16 tracks, so that's half the album right there by Domino. So you know it's really dope just based off that. And then Casual is one of the illest MCs on the West Coast, period. But he's also arguably the best MC in the Hieroglyphics crew. I personally go with Pep Love as my number one. Just stylistically, I prefer his the depth of his lyrics and the subject matter a little more. But Casual, as a punchline rapper, is probably the number one in Hieroglyphics. I wouldn't want to see him in a battle ever. and most people probably feel that way too. But Casual produces also, and he produced 6 beats on here as well. So that's 14 tracks right there, just between Domino and Casual. And then the other two, Del the Funky Homo Sapien produced 1 beat, and then J-Biz produced 1 beat. Who I mentioned, J-Biz produced for Pep Love's first album, The Shaman, and he also did the last track on Third Eye Vision. Really dope producer as well. And then as far as the features, there's not many features on here at all, because Casual can hold his own on any beat at any time, in any place. But Saphir is featured on here, who Casual and Saphir have a history. They had a battle at one point, and they were beefing a little bit over what seems like a misunderstanding, but they kept it on some hip-hop. Unless it got further than that, it may have gotten further than hip hop onto some street level stuff. But they definitely were in the studio with Sway back in the day, battling right on the spot, which is pretty dope. So he's featured on an interlude on this album. Del the Funky Homo Sapien is featured on 2 tracks. He's on here twice, and then Pep Love is featured on a track with Del. And those are the only features. So let's get into this album. Starts with an intro produced by Domino.
This
really sets the tone. Man, if you don't know Souls of Mischief, Hieroglyphics, you're missing out on some of the best funk in hip-hop history. So Casual is also no stranger to freestyling off the top of his head, even on an official album, which is pretty dope. You hardly rarely hear that, and if you do, it's probably like the 3rd or 4th, 5th take, and you don't even know if it's genuinely a freestyle or not. Casual, I don't think, gives a crap about any of that. He's probably just going to freestyle right off the top of his head on the spot without prepping anything, like he did on the intro of this album here, because that's just what he does. And when he battled Saphir, I think Saphir was coming with writtens, Casual was coming off the top of his head, so he's just kind of used to that, you know what I mean? He'll be underprepared and feel confident enough to take on anybody. But he starts off the album with a freestyle off the top of his head. That's pretty rare. I don't know anyone else who's really done that. Let's go into the next track called You Flunked. It's produced by Casual himself. Great album in the car, especially on a sunny day like today.
Listen, I guess the G does not possess the recipe. The sale been fell
Damn. All right, moving on to the third track. It's called Mio Mayo, produced by Domino. Alright, next track, Got Off It, produced by Casual again. And I love the production on a lot of these. The beat switches mid-verse like this. Oh, maybe it didn't there. My bad. Oh, yeah, there it is. Oh, fuck. So yeah, I love when the beat switches midway through the verse and it's a different loop or a different sample they throw in there. It just adds to it. And then the beat switches during the chorus again. Then they drop the drums out for the start of the next verse. Great production. They didn't just like loop a beat for 3 minutes. Like they're in there making great songs. Next track is called That's How It Is. This is produced by Del the Funky Homo Sapien, who, like I said, I was trying to find some beats off his first album to use, ended up going with Fear Itself by Casual. But this is also some of Casual's first appearances, because this is 94, I believe this is 93. So Casual may have his first appearances on Del's solo album here, No Need for Alarm, which is so freaking good. So freaking good. And I have it on vinyl too. I just decided to go with the Hi-Ro vinyl. And over here, I got He Think He Raw, which is a dope Casual solo album. Also, I got it on vinyl. I don't have it on CD, but I have the Hierophant, which is really dope. My favorite song on here is Hip Hop Fiend, or Fiend for Hip Hop. Fiend for Hip Hop. Check that out. That's my favorite track on here. Dope. All right, so back to this album, though. This next track is That's How It Is, produced by Del. Del on the beat. Next track's called That Bullshit. This is featuring Saphir. It's just like interlude. Mad funny. Produced by Casual. And then the next track is Follow the Funk. And this is produced by... Let's see. Produced by Domino as well. Next track, Who's It On? This is featuring Del and Pep Love. So you got three of my favorite Hieroglyphic members on the same track. Produced by Domino. It's Pep Love. Cause beat switch. I'm just gonna hear Dell come in on this because I really like his verse on here as well. Dell. I can't get enough of that shit. Next track is I Didn't Mean To, produced by Casual again. It's just funky and hard and just raw. And the next track's the one I use. It's called We Got It Like That. I called it The Way That I Got It. We kind of flipped it a little bit, but it's pretty much just a remix to this beat. Not gonna say I outdid Casual, because I definitely didn't, but I love Casual on this. Domino killed this beat. That song never gets old. Glad I got to use that beat on Head Nod Music Volume 2 and was able to find an instrumental. And shout out to Domino, man. He actually commented on the clip of the video I posted yesterday, which is pretty dope. I've been getting some recognition from some of these producers I've been tagging on here and some of the featured artists on some of the albums. Not always the main artists I'm reviewing, but that's pretty cool for me, man. Just to get a little bit of recognition from some of my favorite producers and MCs out here. And I love paying homage to him, as you could tell. Actually, was in a really bad mood today for some personal stuff going on in my life. But I don't feel the way right now. So that's why I do hip hop. That's why I do what I love every day. Because without that, man, I may not even be here. Okay? So, not to get too deep. All right, A Little Something is the next track, number 11. Featuring Del the Funky Homo Sapien, Casual on the beat. Yeah, I fucking love hip hop, man. I will display my dynamics, get out the way, damn it. I plan it just to leave them seas abandoned. Brandon X's when I flex this. I wreck shit and leave rappers searching for the exit. Let's get physical. I got precision skill. This is Del. That's just dope. All right, so you got Casual destroying the production on there, first of all. And then Dell and Casual going back and forth on the mic, destroying that. Great combo. They got great chemistry together. Totally distinct, different voices. I mean, Dell is one of the most unique original minds in hip-hop history, man. The guy's just different. And Casual is too, man. You're not going to find anyone. I can't even compare him to anybody, really, honestly. This next track's number 12. This is How We Rip Shit. It's produced by Jay Biz, who I said produced for Pep Love on his first album, The Shaman. Like I said, I can't find that on CD. I would love to get that physically. If anybody knows if they made that, let me know.
Trying to
the beat switch again. That's why you can't just skip through real music that came out back in the day. You can't just skim through it for 10 seconds and be like, oh, I get the gist of that. It's like, nah, there's beat switches. Like, you're missing this. You gotta listen to the whole song or don't even bother. If you're listening to albums like that came out like this or the albums that I make, you gotta listen to the whole song or your opinion does not matter. Do not voice your opinion if you don't listen to a song front to back. I hate that shit, bro. Don't skim through music, bro. Especially if we're not making microwave music. I don't post no microwave music. I don't make microwave music. And I don't fuck with it. Okay, so don't skim through music because we got beat switches in here. We got producers who are going in the extra mile to make that song timeless and that much better. That way I can listen to it. I'm 30 years old now. This came out when I was like 3 years old. I was 27 years old. 27 years ago this came out. And now I'm enjoying it arguably now more than maybe some people did when it first came out. So that's the power of real good music. Lose in the End, this is produced by Domino, track 13. We're winding down on the album here. Domino never misses on the beats, bro. Fits casual style so perfect, too. Another beat switch, you hear that? Damn. All right, track 14, this is one of my favorites. Produced by Domino again. All right, next track, track 15. It's called Chained Minds. Produced by Casual again. This has a beat switch too. I'm pretty sure. Yep. Alright, last track, produced by Domino again, to close it out, it's called B-1000. Not exactly sure what that means, but... So check it out for yourself if you're not convinced already, man. Casual's first album, Fear Itself. And just to clarify, this isn't Dell's first album. This is Dell's second album, actually. His first album is I Wish My Brother George Was Here, which sounds a lot different than this one. This one's like super funky. The production is like crazy on here. I really love this one. I like My Brother George Is Near also, but shout out to Dell. Just wanted to shout out more Dell because I didn't mention him as much when I did the Third Eye Vision because I knew I was doing a Casual episode. But yeah, shout out to Casual Man. He just dropped a new project this year. He's very active still. Check out his later releases as well, including You Think He Raw, really dope one as well. But Fear Itself, man. Shout out to Domino on the production, Casual on the production, and on the mic as well. As always, he'll never let you down as an MC. He's got a lot of enthusiasm on the mic. He makes you smile, but he'll also tear anybody's head off too. Got a sense of humor. Like I said, great during the summer months when it's nice warm weather. I'm from New York, so I tend to bump Hieroglyphics and Souls of Mischief and these guys during the summer most of the time. Take a break from the Wu-Tang a little bit. But yeah, definitely check this out. Check out the rest of their stuff. The Hierophant, Fina Hip Hop. Check out that song, Fina Hip Hop. If you don't like that track, then you might as well not. You have a different taste than me, and that's okay. You know what I mean? But like, I have a very specific kind of taste in hip hop, but it encompasses a lot, man. If someone's coming from a real place and they're not like overly marketing themselves and they're really representing who they are and they found their voice as an artist, like I mess with that. Plus people who are more skilled than me at rapping, I always mess with that. So shout out to Casual, Hieroglyphics, Souls of Mischief, The Homage Continues, episode 11. I plan on keeping it going. There's been some things that have happened in my life recently. I'm going to still try to do one video a week and keep things going because I have a lot of good momentum musically. But I seem to notice that whenever things are going really good for me musically, everything else in my life is like shit. So just kind of getting used to that, pushing through and not getting too high or too low. You know what I mean? Trying to stay centered. But I appreciate all the new fans I've been getting. Yeah, I just had this thought recently where it's like this stage of my life, I feel like I don't have friends. I just have fans, or my fans are my friends. So I love you guys. And you know, I'm all in it. I'm all in this. It's all I got is this music. And I could have other things, but it just doesn't mean anything to me. It doesn't mean anything to me. This means so much to me is the music. And not only just as a fan like this, but like putting on these guys to you. That means a lot to me. I want you guys to know these people. Because if you don't know these people, you don't know where I'm coming from. If you don't know Killer Priest, you don't understand what kind of level of lyricism is out there that you're able to like learn from like music with messages. And like, I'm not knocking anybody who doesn't do that, but that's what I do. And don't knock me for what I do. Because man, chances are you ain't putting in as much work as me for this craft and for this art form. All right, and I'm not trying to make this more than it is. This is about Casual and Fear Itself, but this is about hip hop and what it means to me as well. And The Homage Continues, because I love paying homage to these guys because they saved my life on a daily basis. These guys saved my life because if it wasn't for these guys, I don't know, man. I don't have many people I could rely on a daily basis that really speak to me and are able to keep me going. So I know I'm that for some people. Not many, but I'm that for some people, and that keeps me going. So if I'm that for you, just know you mean the world to me, and I do this for you as much as I do it for myself. I love you all. Peace.